Jesus. There's power in the name of
Jesus.
There's healing in the name of
Jesus.
There's salvation in the name of
Jesus.
The Bible says that demons tremble at the sound of that name. Jesus. My sweet rose of Sharon. My lily of the valley. Oh, that's the reason I say that.
Jesus is the answer for the world today. Above him there's no other, 'cause Jesus is the way.
Jesus is the way.
Jesus is the way.
Let me tell you.
Jesus is the answer for the world today. Above him there's no other. Jesus is the way.
Sing it, Sandra.
If you have some questions in the corners of your mind and traces of discouragement, she cannot find reflections of your past seem to face you every day. But this one thing I do know, that Jesus is the way.
Jesus is the answer for the world today.
Above him there's no other.
Above him there's no other. Jesus is
cannot climb. I know your skies are dark. You think the sun won't shine. In case you don't know, but the word of God is true, and everything he's promised, he will do it for you. That's the reason I say
Jesus is.
So many choices, but it's only one way, and that one way is Jesus. Let me get you, go ahead and type in those comments. Jesus is the only way. Good morning, family. Praise the Lord, saints of God. Truly, I pray that all is going well on this Super Sunday morning. Truly, if this is your first time joining us, truly, we are so elated to have you with us. You carved out some of the time out of your busy schedule, so I pray that God has a word for you on this morning. And if you've tuned in before, welcome back. Truly, we are so glad to have you again. And we pray that you will continue to join us over and over and over, and that God will continue to bless your hearts, your minds, and your spirits. Truly, in this morning, we pray that God has a word for you that will change you around. First, giving honor to God, who is the head of my life. Truly, I thank God for salvation. I thank God for the blood of Jesus. The blood, it heals, delivers, and it sets us free. So this morning, I encourage you to get to know Jesus. Truly, I'm grateful for everyone who makes up the fivefold ministry. I'm grateful for my husband. He's the best. Truly, I am so blessed on this morning. And I'm grateful for my son. He is such a help to me. And truly, I am grateful for my leaders. I salute Bishop Dr. and Co-Pastor Bell. Truly, Bishop Dr. Bell is the pastor of the Bible Way House of Prayer Incorporated. And he is a power-packed man of God. And he is in leadership with co-pastor Diana Bell. And I tell you truly, they are a great partnership. They are pioneers teaching us, preaching, and telling us about the good news of Jesus Christ. So we don't have any excuses on this morning. Truly, Bishop Dr. and co-pastor Bell, they give us a spiritual word. They give us marriage tips. They give us health tips. They encourage us to live on this morning. So we're having everything we need, both naturally and spiritually. So I am blessed, and I love my leaders. If you love your leaders on this morning, let me see you put some hearts out there. Let me see you give me some thumbs up. Let me see you say, Lord, I'm grateful for my leaders. I love Bishop Dr. and co-pastor Bell. And truly, the motto at the Bible Way House of Prayer is, we believe in giving everyone a chance. And I'm just fortunate, and I'm just grateful that God has afforded me the opportunity to stand before you as the intermediate Bible teacher on this morning. And I just pray that I will be able to say something to just touch your heart on this morning. The title of today's lesson is Micah Stands Firm for God. Micah Stands Firm for God, and it's coming from Micah, the second chapter, the 4th through the 11th verse. There is always a tug of war going on. The will to do right versus the will to do wrong. Whichever will you succumb to will have supreme control over every decision that you make. There is an old proverb that says, one should not carry out an action if he or she is unwilling to handle the consequences. Have you heard the saying, don't do the crime if you can't do the time? According to the Urban Dictionary, this was a hip expression of the 1960s and 1970s that advises you not to do something unless you are willing and able to accept the full weight of the consequences. The lesson exposition tells us, in this week's lesson, we discover Israel on the brink of harsh punishment. The people had long enjoyed their pleasure of sin without any regard for God's sentiments. All of the immorality, all of the adultery, and taking advantage of the poor was now coming to an end. They would be entering into a season of reaping what they had sown. This brings me to my first point on this morning. Take heed to the warning. Take heed to the warning. If we back up to verses 1 through 3, They tell us that the people of Israel were straying further and further away from God. They were corrupt and full of iniquity. It said that they lay awake long hours devising a plan to do evil. Do you know anybody like that? They're up all hours of the night coming up with plans to do evil, to destroy somebody else. It says they were making money from false prophecies. They were oppressing the poor. They were coveting their neighbors' fields and houses, and they were seizing them. It says that they were robbing people of their inheritance. They were living to please themselves, and they were out to get whatever they wanted at no cost. It wasn't a fair way of living, and they did not have a moral compass. And see, the same thing is going on in the world today. People are making gods of themselves, and they are doing whatever they can to take everything that you have. You see, God sent Michael to tell the people, enough is enough. The people of Israel were going to reap the harvest they sowed, and God was going to remove the blessings from them. He was going to take away their property. They were going to be forced into captivity. A day would come when their enemies would take over and control them. There would be no reprieve. The people would come against them and mock them and taunt them. You see, despite the fact that they were doing all of these things, Micah had a call from God to stand firm and tell the people enough is enough. They needed to stop what they were doing, and eternal damnation was upon them. He wanted to let the people know what God said, but the people would not listen. They would not heed the warning. In the lesson exposition, it said, yet in our own day, how many actually believe the preacher when he or she speaks about judgment and about hell? When you have the man and the woman of God talking to the congregation and trying to teach them and trying to encourage them to tell you to turn from your wicked ways, how many people actually listen? How many people actually want to change? But it followed up with another question that says, but how many preachers are actually teaching on these topics? How many people are actually trying to tell their congregation, no, you cannot do that, or no, you cannot do this, or no, you cannot go there? We live in a time, if the preachers talk to the congregation about facing the consequences for their actions, they just simply say, you're judging me. They say that we live under grace. But how many knows if you're living right? You have every right to tell someone when they're right and when they're wrong. God forgives, but we cannot continue to live the lives that we are living. Paul tells us in Romans 6 and 23, shall we continue in sin so that grace may abound? Truly, God gave us in the Old Testament, God gave us the Ten Commandments, and it tells us not to steal, not to covet what our neighbors have. The Bible tells us in Mark 12, 30 through 31, love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind, and all your strength, and love your neighbor as yourself. There is no commandment greater than these. You see, we can't continue to do wrong and mistreat people and think that we are going to get away with it. The wicked will surely die. The evil man will be cut off, and God will pay everyone according to what he or she has done. So when the man and woman of God tells us what the Lord says, we cannot turn a deaf ear. it would behoove us to take heed, because warning comes before destruction. And like Micah, today God is sending men, women, boys, and girls to tell us when we are living unrighteous lives, and they are telling us the way that we should go. And if we take heed and if we change our ways, we won't have to suffer the consequences like the people of Israel. Point two, Lord, save me from myself. Lord, save me from myself. You see, we can't believe everything that we think. Everything that our mind conjures up, every thought that comes up in our heads, we cannot believe in them. Sometimes your mind will try to set up negative thoughts and will keep you blinded to the truth. Your mind will have you listening to people who aren't telling you the truth, because yourself, your flesh, me, does not want to be brought under subjection. Lord, save me from myself, because sometimes I am my worst enemy. Type that in the comments. I can be my worst enemy. I can stand in the way of progression. I can stand in the way of growth. Self and flesh will keep you in the shape that you are in. Verse 6 shows us how flesh kicked in. Self did not want to be reprimanded. And we see here in verse 6 that the false prophets stood up against Micah. And it wasn't just the false prophets. I can just see all the little unhappy sinners, the people who weren't doing right, they stood up against Micah. And they were telling Micah, we don't want to be prophesied to. We don't want to be preached to. We don't want to be told that we are doing wrong. They didn't want to hear what Micah had to say from the Lord. But how many knows that movie tells us that God is trying to tell you something? My lesson exposition says that it was like a constant drip of a leaky faucet. Think about when our man and woman of God, they're giving us a word from the Lord. How many of us are just sitting and looking at the preacher, but our eyes are not focused enough, our minds are not focused enough, our brains are just far away from what the man and woman of God are saying? It's like a drip of a leaky faucet, a nagging faucet that you just want to shut up. When the true men and women of God speak up for righteousness, self, somebody will always come in to try to keep you from repenting, will try to keep you from changing, will try to keep you from acknowledging your faults, will try to keep you from being accountable for your wrongdoings, and will try to keep you from becoming a better person. You see, Satan doesn't want us to change. He's always going to allow distraction to come in the form of false teachers, in the form of our family, in the form of our friends, in the form of anything that we know can get our attention. But, saints of God, we have to pray. Lord, save me from myself. Save me from my thoughts. Save me from anybody and anything that will keep me from moving forward. If you want to be saved from yourself, if you really want to be changed, I need you to type in the comments, Lord, save me from myself. Lord, save me from what I want to do. Save my flesh from what it wants to partake in. Lord, help me to do what's right. Truly, Lord, I want to be right. Lord, I want to be saved. And Lord, I want to be whole. My final point on this morning is don't become an enemy to God. Don't become an enemy to God. You see, the people of Israel today had become enemies to God. Why do you say that? Well, if you're doing wrong, if you're mistreating people, if you're rejecting the word, if you're rejecting the messenger, if you're rejecting the man and woman of God, if you're refusing to change, you are an enemy to God. In verses 8 through 11, the people didn't want to see the wrong that they were committing. Micah was coming to them, and today the preachers are coming to us, letting us know, but we're blinded by our thoughts, and we're saying we're still good people. How many people do you know that are backstabbing and seeking to destroy and taking from their neighbors and doing all kinds of malice, but they still feel like they're good people? That's what's going on in today's lesson. And I'm going to read to you the Message Bible, verses 8 through 11. This translation says, "What do you mean?" Michael was telling them, "What do you mean you're good people? You're the enemy of my people. You rob unsuspecting people out for an evening stroll. You take their coats off their backs like soldiers who plunder the defenseless. You drive the women of any people out of their ample homes. You make victims of children and leave them vulnerable to violence and vice. Get out of there, the lot of you. You can't take it easy here. You've polluted this place, and now you're polluted and ruined. And if someone showed up," now this verse right here, this one is what's really going on. It says, "But if someone showed up with a good smile and a glib tongue and told lies from morning to night, I'll preach sermons that will tell you how you can get anything you want from God. More money, the best wines, you name it. You'd hire him on the spot as a preacher." And that's what's going on today. We don't want to hire preachers who want to tell us to be changed, who want to tell us how we can be saved for real, who want to tell us how to be like Christ. We don't want preachers like that. We want preachers that are going to encourage us to just keep living, encourage us to live under grace and live under mercy. We want people to tell us that we're going to be blessed abundantly, want to preach wealth and to preach an abundance of things. We want to hear a word from them, but we don't want to hear a word from a Micah. We don't want to hear a word from someone who has been sold out to follow Jesus. You see, we can't be like the people of Israel. We don't have to be this way. All we have to do is just turn about faith and march on, because those of us who are on the battlefield for the Lord, we will make it in as long as we're striving each and every day to be like Christ. We have to turn to God, and we have to listen to the preachers. We cannot seek after preachers and pastors who are living unrighteous lives and who are telling us just what our ears want to hear. I had a coworker that I used to sit next to some years ago who told me about a mega church that he attended. He said that his pastor was relatable. He said that he loved his church because his pastor was cheating on his wife. His pastor was doing all kinds of things, and he felt like this was the perfect place to be because this is who he was. He was having babies out of wedlock. He was drinking. He was smoking. He was doing everything that you can name, but he felt comfortable being at this church because the pastor wasn't right. So he had an excuse to live by way of the pastor. But saints of God, we cannot live this way. This is not the life that God is calling us to. Saints of God, God is calling us higher. God is calling us to change. God is calling us to treat people right. He's calling us to live right. And if we don't, we will have to pay the price for the crime. God has some genuine leaders and some genuine preachers out there. And if you are in need of someone who will love your soul and who will treat you like a parent and tell you what is right, Bishop Dr. Bell is who you want to watch and shepherd over your soul. He will love on you and just like a parent. You think about it, sometimes our parents will, they will reprimand us, they'll fuss at us, they may even whoop us, but guess what? It's because we got out of line. But if you just take what they've said to you, take that whooping, you will grow and you will see that it will help you become a better person. And that's what Bishop Dr. Bell has for us. Truly, he has a well-balanced meal. He'll give you meat, he'll give you vegetables, he'll even top it off with dessert. But we have to have an ear to hear what God is saying. We have to have eagle's eyes. And I always say that when I'm getting ready to turn the service over to Bishop Dr. Bell, we have to have eagle's eyes. An eagle can only focus at one thing at a time. So we have to focus on the man of God as he gives us a word from the Lord that we need to open our hearts to hear and receive so that we can be changed. Saints of God, when God sends us a warning to turn back to him through the man and woman of God, we cannot get our little crew together. We cannot revolt. We cannot stand up against the truth. We must tell ourselves, self, stand down. Stand down. Type that in the comments. Self, stand down, not down. Because God wants us to go higher. God wants us to grow. And instead of us becoming enemies to God, we should become friends of God. Because God is a friend that loves at all times. He's there with us. He's there for us. But how many knows if we don't do what's right, we will have to suffer the consequences. So seek after righteousness and true leadership and someone who is concerned about our souls. We have to be concerned about our souls and thank God for our Michaels. Somebody type in the comments, I'm thankful for my Michael. I'm thankful for someone who is willing to tell me when I am wrong and I need to be willing to accept when I am wrong. Can we get you to do that on this morning? Can we get you to have a heart to change? Truly, I have enjoyed teaching you this lesson on this morning. Truly, God is calling for ready people. God is calling for us to change, and God is calling us to do right. And we must know if we do not do what we're supposed to do, we will be punished. God will take all of those blessings away from us. Amen. Truly, before I end on today, I would like to invite you to invest in the ministry. I would like to invite you to sow a seed to help further the vision of our leaders. We have five options for you to give. Truly, you can give online at www.thebibleweighhouse.org, or you can text to give, text all caps, G-I-V, the number 2, T-B-W-H-O-P, to the number 502-650-9147. Or you can give via Cash App. Everybody has Cash App, right? You can give to our hashtag, $TheBibleWay, $TheBibleWay. Or you can mail a donation to P.O. Box 8310, Birmingham, Alabama, 35218. And our fifth way is in person. We're in person in this sanctuary on 1st, 3rd, and 5th Sunday, and we're located at 3501 Avenue F, Birmingham, Alabama, 35218. If you're not doing anything, come back and join us at 12 o'clock noon, where our Bishop Dr. Bell will have a word for you, and I promise you, the man of God has a word to uplift your spirit, to encourage you, and to help you along this journey. So wherever you are in your life, just carve that time out. If you're in your car, if you're at home, join back in with us at 12 o'clock noon. And we always end by telling you to stay safe. Truly, it's so many diseases out there, so much danger in the land. So just stay safe. Look out for yourself. You got to be watchful. Truly, it's so much again going on in the world. So you got to be watchful and prayerful. And Satan and all of his devices, he's trying to distract us. But we have to stay focused. Truly, we have to stay prayerful. Pray for your neighbors. Pray for your friends. Pray for yourself so that self won't get in the way. Pray for the men and women of God. They are trying to keep us in the fold. Truly, we have to stay strong. Stay strong because God is going to give us the strength, the courage to endure, and we have to live. Truly, Bishop Dr. Bell, he gave us a message some years ago that said, you haven't lived until you live a little longer. So just keep on living, saints of God. And as I close, we have to wait on God. Wait on God to give us direction. When he sends someone to tell us what to do and to tell us what to say, to tell us where to go, we have to have a heart, a mind to be obedient. Lord, show me the way. Truly type in those comments. Lord, I need you to show me direction. Lord, I'm waiting on you so that I will listen, so that I will do and say and go where you want me to go. Truly, God bless you on today, and we look forward to seeing you soon.
Tell me what to do.
Tell me what to do.
Please tell me.